Yeah, get the other bowl out.
Now we're back. I almost lost that entire filter. All right, let's try this again. Almost lost my filter, almost lost the back side of the camera and the mount, all in one fell swoop. Hopefully we'll see some turtles out here. Almost lost it all right there off the side of the boat. So we are on the Holokai catamaran, left from the Waikiki outrigger outrigger reef, right straight in front of us. We're out about, I'm not even sure, I didn't want to guess, over a mile out, I guess. Seems like it. So if we get 100 Holokai catamaran tags on this stream, we will definitely do a 2 catamaran pass giveaways. Guys, I don't think those are, Joe, that one for sure is not correct. Whenever you get a correct tag, you do Holokai, and it comes up in a link, like Gerard, that's not correct. When you do a correct tag, it will look like a tag. I don't think Janet is here, but so we can have her show you what it looks like. Shasta, can you do one?
Yeah, I was just about to do that.
She's doing one right now. So that's Magic Island. That's where we were yesterday, all the way over to Diamond Head. And I believe we're going out to the other side of Diamond Head. I think that's where we're going to be heading today.
There you go. I just did it.
Watch Shasta's tag that's coming up. So this is like a 40-foot catamaran. I'm not going to give you any type of specifications because we're going to be talking with Ryan, who's the actual captain of the boat. He's going to give us some tips. It's a little bit cloudy looking out that way, but check out this way. It's a beautiful day. Look at that. Just swells out here. It's not choppy at all. Shasta's an inch or two deep in her Mai Tai already. I didn't even see yours, Shasta.
Huh?
I didn't even see your post come up yet.
Oh, I commented twice.
Yeah. Maybe it's Hello, Michelle. Can you see us from your vantage point there in, on the beach?
Oh. It says it ended.
That's not a correct one. When you tag it correctly, Kathy, the at sign doesn't show up. I don't want to take away from the stream so much and explain about the tagging.
I was just listening.
It's a beautiful day. I mean, the ocean here. Look at the water. Look how blue it is. You get a bit of a different perspective of the parasails, and you're out here now looking at the sailboats directly in line with them instead of looking at them from the oh, check it out. I still haven't seen Shasta's post or post come up. Hopefully the I know there's a delay. Nice. Actually under sail and a little power. So they have several sails I want to tell you about. They have the sunset sail. They also have the fireworks sail, which is right here off of Hilton Hawaiian Village right there, and they go over that way a little bit closer, but you see a beautiful view of the fireworks. Oh, it's beautiful, man. It's beautiful being under sail here. Check this out. Yeah, Robin, that's not a correct tag. When it comes up, when you type it and it looks like that with the at sign and Holokai catamaran, that's not a correct tag.
Nice to see it.
You don't have to go to their page and like them. That will help, but you don't have to do that. Yeah, he will. Look at how beautiful the water is. Hopefully that's coming through to you guys. No, she's not. She's right here beside me for right now. They want to know if you're on the net yet. Kathy, I can't. Not yet.
Okay.
You can if you want to.
Whenever you want me to, I'll go there.
That's right. I don't know if those tags are correct or not. Lance, you probably know. Can you tell if those tags are correct? Shasta, can you look at their tags on there and see if some of them are correct?
There is some that were correct.
Yeah. It's just like tagging Waikiki Trolley. I don't want to talk about the tags anymore. There's two cats.
Yep, a lot of them are correct. I just looked
good.
At it.
Good, good. Beautiful to see. There's the Kaimana Hotel right over here, right by Sansochi Beach. There's a war memorial right there that is Barefoot Beach Cafe. That's the concrete pier that we come out on sometimes on sunrise streams and sunset streams. We've seen some baby marlin, as you guys have noticed, and some sea turtles. And that's Queens Beach right beside it, and then Kohio Beach. How many of those hotels can you guys name? Probably all of them. Ruth, that's not a correct tag. If you check out, not trying to point you out, Ruth, but if you see Ruth's tag or her comment, that's, if your comment looks that way, that's not a correct tag. When it's a correct tag, it looks like what Kathy's is right now. Yeah, they normally put some lines out when they fish. This guy's actually got a fishing line and rod and reel right by my waist here. We'll get an interview with Ryan a little bit later, not right now. On our way back, after we hit our peak and come back, we'll get a little interview with Ryan.
Cheers.
Yeah.
What is this? Yeah. What is it?
You said a refill?
Yes. What is the drink?
Oh, so it's our Holokai Hooch.
Okay.
It's a combination of passion. Wagyu juice mixed with some rum and schnapps.
Awesome. Okay. Yeah. Thanks.
Yeah. You're like, yeah, give me a.
I don't want to grab my wallet out right now because drop
it's
it.
Bar. It's open bar.
I know, but I still want to. I'm gonna tip after.
I mean.
Whatever you think.
Yeah.
Well, those are a couple good drops. Look at how beautiful Diamond Head is from here. That's one of the glass bottom boats right there that we always see, but we see them from the shore.
There you go.
Can I look it up on my phone?
I would like to find something.
I told you not to. They're good, but they're not. They're like they're funky out here that far.
My mic's off.
No problem. Did you want to get on the nets?
Yeah, I can. Let me just take this off.
Well, don't do it. Just do it if you want to do it.
Yeah, I'm going to do it. I'm going to put this away, and I'll go down.
Watch the... I told you. Here you go. This is where... This kind of gives you an idea of how rough it would have been yesterday. Look at how small these waves are. But we're going up and down probably 6 feet or so, more or more. Here you go. Oh. Hello, Michelle. We're waving at you right now, if you can see us. Here we go. It just shows you coming out here how vast the ocean is. I mean, obviously you know that, but it just pays it off a little bit more while you're here. Out here.
I should give you this so it doesn't get wet.
Is it on or off?
Off.
Okay.
I didn't have it on sometimes.
She's going to get soaked on these as we hit these white caps coming up here. When you're when we're here in whale season, you're able to see whales, especially when you come out here. See the lighthouse right there, the Diamond Head Lighthouse. All along this channel along here, you see whales, pods. You'll see the mothers and the babies. They're on their way over to Maui, which is right over there, or back from Maui. No telling. But how about that beautiful view, huh? I'm gonna go back here in the back. Excuse me, sir. So we can see this whole. Yes, she will definitely get wet in the net.
Oh, beautiful.
Man, I love going to the park at the top.
Oh, we love it up there, yeah.
Oh, we're right there. Oh, really?
Right up there is the Wahila Park Reserve that we looked at, that we did that little hike from, right up there where the pine trees are. Right next to it is the Wilhelmina Rise. Right at the bottom there is Kaimuki. We went through that little tour of the town the other day. Look at how beautiful this view is.
Yeah.
Yes, happy Father's Day to everybody that's out there. Make sure you're liking and sharing the stream if you're enjoying it. We appreciate it. The blue of this, hopefully it's coming through the way it's reading on the camera here. It's just beautiful.
And I always see myself
doing it.
It's a pretty sizable boat. I think it's a 40 footer. I'm not sure. We'll talk to Ryan about it here, whenever he's done with this guy. Check out Shasta up there. In the net, but we're not flashing too much. We're not hitting too many white caps. That's why it's not rising and falling like it was before. That's Coco Head over there in the distance, and at the foot of Coco Head, that's Hanama Bay and Hanama Bay Ridge, and just to the left of it is Hawaii Kai. How is the audio? Is the wind picking up for you guys? Yes, Janet, thank you very much for that.
Okay.
I don't want to have that. I got a job.
Oh, yes. December. Usually from November to March is when your ideal whaling season is. Keep it.
Sorry. Just making sure you don't lose it. Cheers, guys.
Good. Not really, Kathy. The walkers would be really difficult because you can't get on the boat. Once you're on the boat, that's one thing. But what you can do is you can take one of the catamarans that leave from the harbor. You just can't take a catamaran that leaves like ours did from the shore. That would make it pretty impossible. Not pretty impossible. It would make it impossible.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, we're under sail too. Not completely. So far, the live stream seems to be going well. Is there any connection issues with you guys? Are there any dropouts? Other than the almost literal dropout we had in the very beginning, we're going to do this whole thing again and make sure that the camera is more secured.
Sorry.
And so we'll do that again. Once, yeah, good, all perfect. So there's the Diamond Head Lookout, the lighthouse, and right to the right of there, those are the three little lookouts that we've gone to a couple of times. As you guys know, the stream drops out, but...
Actually, no, that's not the lookouts over there. That's Aina Haina and Hawaii Kai. And then that's Hanama Bay over there. Other side, and then Coco Head Stairs is right there. And on the other side of the mountain is where the lookouts are.
That's the Diamond Head Lookout right there, and that's the Lighthouse Lookout right there.
Oh, I thought you were talking about the other lookouts, sorry, that you go to all the time.
So anyway, that's Diamond Head Lookout, that's the Diamond Head Lighthouse, and you can actually see at the very, this peak here, peak right there, and that peak right there, and that's the peak where the pillboxes are for Diamond Head. That's this far right pillbox is the one that's not accessible anymore. And that's Hanama Bay, that's Hanama Bay Ridge, that's Coco Head, that's Hawaii Kai, that's, I don't know what that first one is, the second
Aina,
one.
Aina.
What is it?
Aina Haina.
Aina Haina. The next one is Wilhelmina. Oh, that's Wilhelmina right over there.
That's Wilhelmina.
And right in their valley, that's Manoa Valley right there.
Yep. And then Sandy's is over there.
Sand Beach, right?
Sandy's, yeah. I don't recommend that beach. It's very rough.
How's the audio now? Is the audio too windy or something? I want you to drop it.
Right?
How's that now? The audio should be perfect now. Yeah, I fixed it. It's Mo Better. Mo Perfecto. It'll get windy here for just a second.
Okay. Is that better?
Okay, now try it. Now try the audio. Because I just turned her audio back on. If hers is windy, then we'll just cut it off.
Then I just can't talk.
That's okay. Just let me know. It's okay. So let me know if it's get too windy for you guys. And because we're not in control of our surroundings, it's going to change. But just if it's consistently bad, let me know. How blue is that? I mean, is it crazy? I mean,
it's crazy.
Guys, I am always amazed at how beautiful blue the water is here. So you see, we come out quite far. Look at these seabirds. They're beautiful, are they not? The shade of blue, I've always said this before, that if you painted a picture with the blue, this shade, people would say you're not doing it very realistic. It's too blue. It's too, sapphire is a great word. It's not aquamarine, which I often always say, and it's incorrect, but sapphire, yeah, that's a great description. So how many of you have done the A catamaran? Actually, since we've had such an issue with the catamaran tags, you guys can tag it up to 5 times each. I think I said 2 times earlier. So you can just so we can get the number of tags we need to get, you guys can do up to 5 times. And if you wouldn't mind, please putting a phrase with it. You know, I love Holokai, or make sure you ride Holokai, or I want to ride Holokai. That helps out a lot too. So if you put just a little text with it, I would appreciate it. And then look at the reflection off this back here. How's that? Is that beautiful? It's about an hour and 15 minutes. There you go, Sandy. That's perfect. there you guys go. Now you're talking. So what we may do is, just spitballing here, we may do, take this live stream until we get to the turnaround point, and then do more produced video. I'm not sure. We'll see how it goes.
It's so hard to hear you. Sorry.
Huh?
It's hard for me to hear you.
Yeah, I'll motion to you.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm just telling them that it's choppy. Beautiful blue. I mean, look how dark blue that is. And then when you look out this way, the blue is like completely different blue, isn't it? It's like a black blue.
Mm-hmm. I think it's also the way the light reflects on the water.
Yeah.
That just changes the color.
How's this music for you guys? Type of one if this is your style of music. Number two if it's not. The type of music we've been listening to overall, not just this one song. Let me know. I'm curious about that.
Honestly, I was just snowboarding.
What do you think of it, Shasta?
The music?
The whole thing. Whole thing.
I love it. I definitely recommend Cindy on the Net. You get the full experience, but I do recommend wearing a swimsuit. That way you dry quickly. Definitely walking around. Hopefully you can get your sea legs. If not, just grab onto the railings. I love it. I love being on the water. I'm a water girl, so this is great. And the staff is good and the drinks are awesome. I will say that. This special punch thing they have is really good. It has like rum and something else in it.
Isn't Diamond Head beautiful? Yeah, it's not that loud. I'm trying to not showcase it, but it doesn't matter. We're going to get strikes on this. Like if you use licensed music without permission on a stream and it's audible, you'll get a strike. But maybe they'll let it go because they know the venue. No, I'm not drinking it. Is it sweet?
Sweet? Yeah, try a sip.
No, thanks.
He said it's passion fruit. It's like some of pog, passion fruit, rum, and something else in here.
And beer?
Huh?
And beer?
No.
Oh.
Rum and something else.
Oh.
But with a triple sec, maybe? I don't know. Something. It's really good. Everybody, I'll drink enough for both Tony and I.
Yes, both sails up. He's on sail power and boat. Here we go. Nice. Those kids got ruined.
I saw that. I'm a little bit bummed I wasn't out there for that one.
There's Waikiki, Honolulu. Much of Oahu. How about that for a screenshot, huh?
Yeah.
And on our way back, before we get back, can I get a few minutes with you?
Sure.
Let me get out of your way.
All right, guys, we're going to get a couple minutes with the super duper captain himself.
Hey!
World famous, Ryan. What's going on, brother?
How you guys doing?
Good, how are you?
Good.
So we got people watching from Berlin and Germany, Australia, New Zealand,
wow,
North America.
Wow, all over the world. That's awesome.
Yacine also. So do you, obviously you don't mind being on, so. tell us a little bit about the boat. Tell us what you know, some of your experiences have been. What can some of the people expect to see different times of the year?
So if you're here from predominantly January through March, we get a lot of humpback whales. They all come down from Alaska to have their calves and mate down here. So they'll feed all summer in Alaska on krill, and then they'll come down to Hawaii, hang out here 3 or 4 months, and then the whole time they're here, they don't eat anything. And then they head back to Alaska for the summer where they feed. And then besides that, we see a lot of Hawaiian spinner dolphins. They're around year-round, yeah, but kind of depends a lot on the weather. If it's very windy, you don't see them as much.
Yeah.
And then we see Hawaiian green sea turtles every day, pretty much. And then besides that, a few times a year, we probably get some manta rays and some monk seals,
oh, nice,
and stuff like that, yeah.
And you also have a tour that goes to Turtle Canyon, is that correct? You guys do that, snorkel or no?
Yes, we do.
You do?
Yep.
What's included in that? What can we expect to see?
So that one, you go out, the trip is 2.5 hours. The snorkel is about an hour. We go see all the Hawaiian green sea turtles on the reef. There's actually a cleaning station, so the turtles hang out over the reef and the
What's a cleaning station?
So it's an area where the turtles will predominantly gather, and the fish will come, and they'll pick all the parasites and barnacles,
nice,
and algae off of them. So we'll go there for about an hour, and then we go sail for about an hour.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
But so tell us a little bit about the boat. What is it? How big is it?
So this boat is 45 feet long. It's a custom-built sailing catamaran, but it's all custom-built to pull up on the beach. So we have to have retractable rudders and dagger boards and all of that stuff. And it was built in Portland, Oregon.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And then it was sailed from Oregon down the coast to Alameda in the Bay Area. And then from there, it was brought over to Hawaii. And the trip from Alameda to Hawaii took about 2 weeks.
Oh, no way.
And now it's about 10 years old.
Oh, very good. How long have you been with it?
I've been with the company 10 years.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So, one of the most asked questions that we were asked to ask you, this is like we were looking at it yesterday. So, we do live streams all over Oahu. Yesterday, we were watching the waves at Magic Island. As I was coming back, some of the people, we were sitting at the Edge Bar at the Sheraton.
Yes.
There was a catamaran coming in and in and in. And everybody was like, oh my God, he's going to wreck it. They're going to run it onto the boat. The guy just lifted it, cut out the power, and just like a cloud.
Yeah.
How do you do it? So this is what a lot of us guys who think we know what we're doing, and we go, there's no way he's going to stab that beach.
Yeah.
And you guys put it in like that every time. Is it just experience doing it thousands of times, or
definitely
do you ever get nervous?
A lot of it is. What's that?
Do you ever get nervous?
Sometimes, you know, we get really high tides. Sometimes you have tides, you know, like 2.4 feet. We don't have a lot of beach anymore. There's been a lot of erosion. And then especially when there's big waves, it's definitely a challenge for sure. But at the same time, you know, that's kind of what, you definitely get nervous, but that's kind of what keeps the job interesting as well. Like, if you don't have something to keep you on your toes, you're going to get bored. So,
but it's like new every day. Every sail is a brand new sail, right? Yeah. I mean, you see something different every day.
Yeah. But putting it on the beach is definitely a lot of repetitions, helps you out. A lot of muscle memory on the controls. And then a lot of it is definitely gauging where the wind's coming from, predicting which way it's going to blow the boat. And then also looking behind you to see if there's any waves coming. Yeah.
Really?
Because if you want to time it where one wave will roll under you, and then you're kind of falling up on the backside of that wave. And then if you're coming in a little hot, you can always tap a little reverse and kind of put it up on the beach.
So I do have to ask you too, have you had any accidents yet?
We don't talk about that type of stuff.
Okay.
You don't want to jinx yourself.
That's right. Well, it's like an airline pilot.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Excellent. Well, you've done a great job. I really do appreciate it. Thank you for having us on here.
Thank you, guys.
We're going to be on here. We're going to be on here quite a few times. And guys, when you come on, ask for Ryan.
Yeah.
And his big, better-looking brother.
Other Ryan.
Ryan Square.
All right. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. You've done a great job. So smooth, beautiful weather. So I'm glad you guys made the weather great today.
Oh, it's beautiful. Yeah, perfect.
Yeah.
Perfect day for a sail.
Oh, really. Man. So is this type of wind, is this perfect for you? Or do you like it a little more, a little less?
No, I like it like this. This is just about perfect. Enough to get people wet, a little bump to keep it exciting.
Yeah.
But not too windy to where you can't come out off the island and get the good view of Diamond Head and all that.
The sails coming up is just beautiful.
Yeah.
I know it's old hat to you, you're like, whatever, but go ahead. Just coming out, it's just a beautiful thing. They catch the wind, it's spectacular. Good job. Well done.
And I'll say the drinks are amazing. They can't hear me see what I said. The drinks are great.
You gotta be like this. The drinks are really good. Oh, yeah.
How was that, guys?
The drinks are really good.
Let's thank Ryan. Ryan did a great job.
And this is the Holokai
Ryan Pike. And Ryan.
Water. Oh, okay. I feel like I need a drink after that. Woo!
Let me get up to the front and I'll see if we can't stab some waves. Excuse me, guys. Excuse me. Thank you. Oh, sorry, man. So how many of you would, even if you didn't win a pass, how many of you would do the Holokai? Type in a 1, be honest, type in a 2 if it just doesn't seem like something for you, like maybe you'd get seasick or it's not exciting. How many of you would do it? 1 is a yes, 2 is a no. Oh, Rhonda. Hopefully this is helping ease the pain. 1, 1, yeah. I figured it'd be a lot of ones, but there are some people who just don't fancy it. It's not a something they would like. That Turtle Canyon, we're going to do that trip with Shasta. We're going to give her a underwater GoPro. Maybe see that cleaning station. Here you guys go. Beautiful Diamond Head in the background. Margaret, if you take Dramamine, several people here have taken it. It's no problem. Henry's going to start any minute now, huh, Michelle? All right, guys, do you want to stay on until we park it on the beach? Or have you seen enough? Lance, what'd you think so far? That's a nice shot, huh? With Diamond Head and all the hotels. Ryan did say he had let me park it, so I may try that. I'm kidding. This thing moves. It moves. Fast. Go check out over there. Well, you think walking on those rocks over Magic Beach are a bit treacherous? Yeah, they nailed the music. I know you guys can't hear it that well. I'm trying to stay away from the speakers a little bit on purpose. Can you name all the hotels there in front of us? Waikiki Wendy Silva, did you do this? Did you do this sale? So do you guys think we got over 100 proper catamaran tags? Shasta's enjoying her day out on the water. Hello, Cat Roy. Yes, friendly reminder to like and share. We're going to do this same sale again, probably maybe even later this week. But we're going to do the sunset cruise. What do you say? Yeah, they do a midday, a Turtle Island, where you get out and you get a snorkel. Then they do a sunset. They do this trade winds, and then they do the fireworks on Friday night. And they just park it about right there and watch the fireworks and then bring it in. And they also have drinks. They have drinks on all the sails. And this one they have like unlimited drinks. If you drink and sail, it's a great deal. I mean, for what you pay, rate, I think it's between $60 and $95, I believe the rates are. You can look on their website to be for sure, obviously. But I think it's a great deal. I mean, you come out here, you have a few drinks, some beautiful music, a view of Waikiki and Oahu that you don't normally get to see. I just think it's a great, you're going to spend this money on three drinks or four drinks at any bar, and you're just going to be sitting at the bar. Or you can come out here. What would you like to do? There's just something about watching that sail come out and then go back in. And then fill up and then, just pushes the boat out on top of the waves. Some are, Shirley, but not the one you have. It may say cash bar, but it's not. I would bring cash just to tip them, but it's not cash. The sail that you won, Shirley, is the one that we're on right now. It's the Trade Winds, it's called. Look how nice and beautifully flat it is. But you can see over there, look, you can see the waves going into the marina and harbor there, like from yesterday at Magic Island. You see they're still breaking out quite a way. Oh, well, they're breaking a little bit here too. I couldn't see them before. Right here. We're going to be going in here where there's a channel. You see how there's a flat channel? And you can see all along Waikiki is fairly flat. Not, I don't want to say flat, it's very mild. But look out over there in front of Hilton Hawaiian Village over there. It's a little bit choppy, not much. And there's the Magnum PI helicopter. I think the Trade Winds is a free. Well, it's been free for us. The times I've done it, they just, it's not been a charge. But Shirley, if you come on and they charge you, let me know how much they charge you. I'll pay you back. But they shouldn't. And I'm serious about that. If they charge you, just let me know. I can't imagine you drinking more than $100 or $200 worth. He's taking it down to just sail power. It's just beautiful. Do you hear that, Lance? That's the first step to resolving your problem. Boy, look at the waves over there on Magic Island. I'm just going to hold this still. Hopefully you can see it. It's right straight right there. Watch. Those are the waves we were seeing yesterday. Look how big. There's same size. See them crashing up there? Wow. Boom. Look at that. This is a private sailboat coming at us. The glass bottom boat is right on the other side of it. There's a glass bottom boat there. Two of them, three of them. No, I'm sorry, two of them. And two catamarans. Kind of a last look at Diamond Head there as we come in. Beautiful shot. Yeah, those waves are coming in hot and heavy over there in Magic Island. See the mist coming off of them? Nice. Good job, guys, on the tags with text on them. Appreciate it. Look at just wide open. Oh, very good, Janet. You're a killer. Thank you. Guys, let's get to 100. We're going to be a for sure strict on that. Faux show. Thank you, Janet. That's very, very nice of you. That's Ryan, our other mate. Did a great job, man. I appreciate it. Thank you. You guys did a great job.
I appreciate you guys. Hi there.
I appreciate you especially.
You can be for sure I'm going to get one of those sweatshirts. No, you want me to hold it for what? While you go do that? You want me to hold that while you do that? Yeah. All right, guys, we're back. I wouldn't, Chester. I wouldn't do it. Good, Alan. How are you? We're on the Holokai doing the catamaran sail. We're just wrapping it up. About another 20 minutes or so. Thank you, Linda. Great use of the tag. Guys, make sure you're tagging correct. Read what Janet just typed. That's it. Nicole, that's misspelled. Thank you, Waikiki Wendy Silva. Nice way to spend a Father's Day for some of you guys, I believe. Very relaxing. What do you think, Shasta? How was the day today? I got it right here.
Oh, okay. I think it's great. It's a beautiful day. It's very windy. And the water is just so gorgeous blue. After the heavy rains, I'm glad we didn't do it after that because the water might have been a little bit more brown. So I'm glad we waited for it to wash out.
Me too.
I wish we saw more turtles, but you know. I'm obsessed with turtles, but you know, I think it's great. Captain is amazing. The bartender is great. The alcohol is great.
They said it was a cash bar. It's not a cash bar, is it?
No, today is open bar. They said.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
They may change that. Was it for us? Just for this sale or what?
For this sale, they said it's
open bar. Oh, nice. I guess they change it. I guess they just determine on how many people are here.
Or it might be an honor of Father's Day. Who knows?
Oh, yeah. Maybe because the Shasta was here. Yeah. They knew Lance was on the stream, probably.
I can't wait to show you guys some of the photos I got and some videos.
Nicole, if your tag looks like what yours is, where it actually, when you're done with it, it has the at sign on the front of it that's not correct. Robert, do one more of those. Do one more like that. Let's see the outcome. Jan, it needs to be no at sign, just all Holokai catamaran. I know, Lance. Oh, here, a little free bird for you, Lance. Can you hear the, here, let's go over here so we can hear some of the music. This would be a good song to come into port with.
Okay.
Can you hear the song? The music? You guys need some spelling lessons. You're welcome, Robin. Perfect, there you go. Once you learn to tag, once you get the tagging down once, it's easy. You never have to be reminded, it's easy to do. Nope, nobody got sick. Aloha, Carolyn.
Closer to shore, the water turns more aqua versus deep blue.
Check out this gentleman right here. He was a guy who was on the sail right when I walked on. He's the owner of this boat. It's the gentleman right there in front of us with the son on the surfboard. They actually, I mean, how cowboy is this? He took the catamaran out to here, jumped off, and he and his son went surfing. And they said, we may be picking them up, maybe not, I'm not sure. That's him right there, these two people. Oh man, that's gonna be so, cool, picking them up. If we do, I don't know if we will or not. Oh yeah, I think he's gonna pick up the line. Yeah, he is. Check this out. Oh, check how cowboy is this. Oh, did you see him? There he is. Dude threw him out a rope, and now he's towing back. Oh, was it not tied up? Oh no, now he's got to go in after it.
Get it, Ryan.
Your job's on the line. He threw the rope in, but it wasn't tied off. And that's his boss. That's the guy who owns the boat. Oh, he is. Only on one of the streams we do, huh? Isn't that cool? So when I don't know if you remember, but when we came out and we started seeing these waves break, and I was making a comment about it, this owner and his son just jumped off the back on their boards, and they've been surfing these breaks since we came on. And this guy, Ryan, just killed it. killed the engine. But the guy threw the line out, and the line wasn't tied to the to the boat. That is hilarious. Like and share, guys. Let's get a this is probably not the best. Didn't turn out to be the best quality stream, but we're going to come back and do probably a produced video. So what did you guys think of the live? Did you like the live getting on? Some of the production problems, almost losing the lands, audio issues. Overall, scale of 1 to 5, what would you give it? And please don't feel you have to say 5. Give me an honest 1 to 5. What would you, 5 being the best? I mean, that's part of doing the live streams. That's why I don't like the, I don't want to sway you any way or the other. Just let me know. 1 being terrible, don't want to watch it, do a produced video next time. Or 5, it's perfect, want to see it again. Please be honest. That's the only way we can make these perfect for you. Perfecter. How cowboy is this? This man back there in the back, that's he and his son. Isn't that a wonderful time for he and his son? Look at that. See him hanging off the back of the boat, just getting hauled in. That's wonderful.
Tomorrow we can go to Monkey Pod.
Yeah.
My
I could do that.
Can you be normal for 5 seconds?
Alrighty, guys. One last picture. There you go.
Do I need to get down?
Yeah, I'm going to have everybody scoot back just behind the mast. We just got to clear up this front area.
Okay, very good. How beautiful is this, huh? Oh, we're going into the Hale Kalani Beach, I believe, right there. Here you go, Janet. Here you go, amigo. Thank you very much for that.
Thanks, brother. Appreciate that.
That's a gentleman. How's this? Oh, let me go over here for you guys. Okay. Oh, how's that view of your favorite place there? Sure.
Gotta work tomorrow. I don't think they're gonna get that nuts. I think tomorrow
I should work too. I actually didn't even see how many ones, twos, threes, fours, or fives. I'll have to check it back. I think he's gonna turn it around. Unless he's going to put us over here on the other side. There's the Waikiki Shore. Outrigger Reef.
That was pretty good.
I would almost say classic.
If he tries to deny it, I got video for the highest bidder.
Yeah. We're like, edit that part. It's April Fool's.
Happy Father's Day. There's a rope.
Frustration and Rich's voice. Didn't tie it.
I don't know, Janine. I'll ask. Are either of the Ryans single?
Right? Single? Furry Ryan is single.
Furry Ryan is single?
Oh, yeah.
A guy named Gary in San Diego wanted to know.
People commenting?
Yeah. No, they said, are either the
Gary.
Ryans?
Oh, nice.
They said, are any of the Gary's single? Are the Ryans single?
Hello. Yeah. Yeah.
You're
This is the part that never ceases to amaze me. When they try to get, when they try and get a landing spot, a lot of people will just sit there and stare at them. Or take selfies or, you know. Look at this water. How beautiful is it, huh? We played it just for you, Ruth. Watch him just bang the sucker right. Boy, this water is much calmer than coming in yesterday, huh? Here's someone else's favorite song, I know.
You guys see the monk seal?
Where?
Right
oh, yeah.
There.
Oh, yeah. Look at the seal. Big old fat seal on the water. Look how sandy he is, huh? That's a big one. I'll bet that's the same one that was over at Kaimuki. I mean, Kaimana. It's about 79, I think. Can you see him? Can you see the sandy monk seal over there? Right there.
Hi guys, thanks again for coming out. Thanks for back, the Safe to Distance Bar. Happy Father's Day.
Yep, did a great job, Ryan. Thank you, brother.
We're trying to get our daughter into preschool.
You're good to go. Just watch your step on the last one.
Okay, so study must stop.
Hey, get
your retirement too.
Here in my car.
Oh, nice. I like that.
Thank you guys. Thank you guys.
Take care.
Take care. Perfect job, brother.
Oh, thank you guys thank you, so much. You guys good take job. Care. Have a good one.
Timing, as with all things, is important in getting off one of these. Let's see if Shasta. Shasta's either going to nail it. I was just waiting. I knew to have it. I think he's asking me something. Okay, guys, look at this. We'll take a look at the monk seal.
We always give you our all when you fly with Southwest.
There you go. How about that? It was a beautiful sail, huh? Too close. Well, no, they have. Well, I think they are. I think they're too close. They shouldn't be. I think they should be 50 yards, but I think it's 50 feet or 25 feet. It's ridiculously close how close people get and how. Look at his big old face. See his whiskers. He's just dead. Dead to the world. Just dead asleep, I mean. This lady looks at me. What are you saying, Dad? It's alive. I see it breathing. Okay, guys. Any closing words?
I hope you learned a little, laughed a little.
Oh my God, she's not even allowed to. Give it a shot, try it.
No, I don't know.
Try it, try it.
I hope you all had fun. I hope you learned a little, laughed a little. And I hope that if this is your first stream or your last stream, that we appreciate you joining us today. And that we enjoy, and we will miss you until our next stream. I totally butchered it.
Okay, Lance, let's show her how it's done. We hope you laughed a little, learned a little. And I know you did because Janet and Lance were on here. And if this is your first stream, hopefully it's not your last, but it's your last stream. Hopefully you know that I appreciate every single second, minute, hour, day that you spend on these live streams with myself and the Shasta disaster.